All right, everyone, welcome back to 3 AM Cards, and we got a fun one today. Commander Masters Collector Box and Lord of the Rings pre-release kit. We'll start off with Lord of the Rings pre-release kit. I don't think in all the Lord of the Rings openings we did any pre-release kits, because I just got them in a couple weeks ago, actually. I didn't think to buy them at first. All right, so you got a cool little deck box here. It's not very sturdy. Oh, I think I did open one of these off camera. I do believe we got a different die. So that's cool. The other one was all white, though, I think. So I do like that a little better than the green there. Okay, then we get promo pack cards. So these ones are special, as you can see there. Kind of hard to see over camera in the foil. There we go. Yeah, they'll have the year stamped on there. So I get rid of these. I always forget if they're promo cards pre-release. I guess pre-release, because this is pre-release. There's like promo pack cards and all kinds of stuff, but we are going to get 6 draft boosters out of here. So our first, we'll just call it a special card. Not a great one there, but there is another one behind it. And could you imagine like a One Ring or a Nazgul? I think they're always rare, so it can't be Nazgul. But to get a spicy pull in that slot, that would be awesome. Not quite like a box topper, but all right, we get Lobelia, Sackville Baggins. Oh, there you go. There you go, YouTube. Use that. All right, let's see what's in the 6 draft packs. Again, just 6 draft packs, so we can't expect, you know, Hellfire and Brimstone, for lack of better terminology at this moment. King of the Oathbreakers. And Tish Restoration foil, though. We'll take that out of a draft pack. And I'll take the awesome-looking Plains as well. Dominaria United and Kamigawa did have awesome full art lands, but these are definitely some of my favorite, probably since Throne of Eldraine. Display of Power. Ah, Dawn of a New Age in a foil. So Mythic foil out of here. What does this thing do? When ETBs with a hope counter on it for each creature you control, at the beginning of your end step, remove a hope counter from Dawn of the New Age of a New Age. If you do draw a card, then Dawn of the New Age has no hope counters on it. Sack it, gain 4 life. All right, it's not, I mean, it is 2 mana. That's actually pretty good for 2 mana. A lot of low casting cost creatures in here. No land cycling cards yet in the bulk slot. Sourman, as I call him now, of many colors. So another mythic right there. Sourman. Last time I started doing that, I spilled water on the table, so we'll stop right there. No water on the table this time, though. Mournful Avenger. I shouldn't make noises like that. Again, 6 draft packs. What do you expect? We got a Commander Masters collector box after this, so we can't get too greedy. You can, but it usually doesn't end well. There we go. We get a land cycling card there. So Swamp Cycling for 1 generic. Very awesome. Rivendell. Impress the enemy. So 2 rare action. 1 mythic. 1 foil. 1 not. Then an island. Showcase Island. So again, out of draft packs, you can't expect the world. Even though this is where most of my One Ring pulls came from. I think definitely 2 of them came from draft packs, off camera, of course. All right, so our last draft pack here, another Entish Restoration, and we'll take a Forge Anew. Getting play right now in Modern Hammer time, so not a bad pull. Usually sells very easily. All right, so that wasn't too exciting. I still got more of those, but I should really keep those sealed. Maybe one more. All right, guys, Commander Masters, Collector. Oh, my God, that was so reckless. Oh, I thought I, like, cut into the box for a second. We should get some entertainment on this channel, right? Me destroying shit. A lot of people to be cool destroy magic products on purpose. I do it. I don't know, out of fucking stupidity. Nah, I shouldn't say that about myself. I can be a little reckless sometimes, but let's just open Commander Masters Collector. Let's go. We know these boxes have been up and down, more down, but as far as quality of pulls, you usually break even, though, which probably the best you can expect out of a Magic box. But we get the Mark Poole Soul Ring starting off. Again, so much good bulk in here. Sour Discord, so we're getting to the good stuff. Treasure Nabber, I just skipped over this guy before. I didn't read him. And that was a little foolish of me, because 3 mana, 3-2, whenever our opponent taps an artifact for mana, gain control of that artifact until the end of your next turn. So he is a Treasure Nabber indeed. And we got Fable Singer for the Mythic. Zakama, Primal Calamity. Then Orin, Frostfang. So I like to price these ones out by the pack. I wasn't adding the commons, uncommons. Nah, I'll do it this time, why not? Fuck consistency, right? Alright, good bulk in here. None of it's hit my eye yet, except for the borderless cards, of course. So we get Faithless Looting, a Reality Shift. Ah, oh, Fellowore Stone! Really don't think we saw that one yet. At least in a foil. We got Magus of the Wheel, spinning the wheel, everyone discards their hands, draw 7 new cards. Unless you got Narset on the battlefield. Mystic Confluence, Gate Watch Beacon, another Magus of the Wheel, that time in the borderless action, and ooh, there's a spicy one right there, guys. At this point, it's probably worth like $30, but I'm just here for the fun, not for the value, because there isn't much, but Demonic Tutor. Borderless, full art, whatever you want to call it, foil on that. And, I do like the artwork, but I think I'll probably sell that and continue to run my revised copies. My boomer magic right there. I'm not even a boomer. I don't know why people say that shit. Alright, 2 more packs left. So we get some counter spells. Arcane Signet. All the glitters downgraded to common, so we get some pauper action. Demon Lord, Boom Pile, didn't know the Boom Pile was in here, so we get foil etched on the Boom Pile. Another Fable Singer, we got that. Ooh, wow, shit. Wow. That's a jewel, oh my god, what is behind that? What is behind, I better not get too excited yet. So I just, wow, Demonic Tutor, now Jeweled Lotus, so yeah, pick the right box here. That was one pack? Wow. So we go Jeweled Lotus to Deflecting Swap Borderless Foil. Jeweled Lotus is obviously the better pull, but I mean, wow. Now, I've been hesitant about selling these things for the ship and rips. One, because I feel like I can't charge that good of a price based off what I get these on. And these are like the two... How many packs have we opened at this point? 12, 16, something like that. That doesn't happen a lot. I don't want to sell you a $60 pack. I open it on the stream. Everyone's watching, your mom and everything. And then you get $12 worth of cards and you want to punch me in the face. I don't know. Maybe I'll put a survey out there if you guys want some collector packs out there. I can do it, but y'all know the risk. Command Tower, very nice. So last pack here. Generous Gift. Caretaker. Grand Abolisher, I like that one right there. Two white mana, 2/2. During your turn, your opponents can't cast spells, activate abilities of artifacts, enchantments, or creatures. Set it out of order, but yeah, not even mana abilities. Usually it says mana abilities, and what a fucking box here. I'm just going to curse. If anyone's watching at this point, put Doubling Season in the comments, because you should be watching at this point, because this has been out of control. So Doubling Season, I said this needed a reprint, we got a reprint, it's right here in front of us in a foil etched. Desecrate Reality, there can't be anything else good in here, right? Like, it has to end right now. Okay, Blood Chief Ascension. Ingrenza, okay, what was I expecting back there after everything else that just happened, so... Yeah, guys, I gotta get this shit sleeved up right away. Where is it? Yes, yeah, so Deflecting Swat, Jeweled Lotus. I keep them in this order here because I want to scan them by the pack, so that's why you're seeing the other stuff in there. But yeah, look at this box, Demonic Tutor, Doubling Season. So this box definitely has to be over $200. If it's not, I'm shocked. And I don't know. Let me know in the comments. Do you guys want me to put these collector packs? I don't know. Maybe I can put like a box of them on the store. Let me know. We'll think about it. But all right, guys. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate everyone that buys from the store, the shipping rips, watches the videos on here, likes, subs, and all that. Thank you. Bye.